Hello everyone, today we'll discuss about the liver, an extremely vital organ. I'm Ume, and before we start, please subscribe to our channel so the next time you'll be updated with our new releases. The liver is shaped like a cone and dark reddish-brown in color. It weighs about 3 pounds. It is located in the upper right portion of the abdomen, just below the diaphragm. This large organ has a very important role in the human body. It regulates most of the chemical processes in the body and excretes a compound called bile as well as certain proteins for blood plasma and makes clotting factors. It also detoxifies and gets rid of harmful chemicals and metabolizes drugs. Liver cells can divide and regenerate fast to compensate for any damage or loss in portions of the liver. But what if the cell keeps dividing uncontrollably? In this case, it might be the liver cancer. Our role today is to answer most of your questions regarding liver cancer. Today we have Dr. Choi, who is a renowned doctor at Hanyang University Hospital in Seoul, Korea. He's going to discuss with us about liver cancer from an experienced point of view.
What is liver cancer?
Liver is something everyone knows, so there is no need to explain what the liver is. Liver cancer is cancer that starts in the liver, but this does not develop for no reason. There are many causes, and in Korea, for example, hepatitis B and in the USA, alcohol-related liver issues, and if left as is for a prolonged period, cancer develops. So in Korea, hepatitis B-related inflammation, and in the USA and the West, it is alcohol-related conditions. Recently, fat people who have fatty livers can also develop cancer, and that is recently increasing a lot. So, liver cancer develops from a variety of conditions. Liver cancer has a variety of causes, but the key point is that if liver inflammation is left alone for a prolonged period, it can develop into cancer.
From what I understood, it starts from diet, right? So it's related to either alcohol...
Hepatitis, liver inflammation, and obesity. Those people can develop inflammation. Some people only develop an inflammation, but if left as is for long periods, it develops into cancer.
So is it like other cancers where it doesn't have symptoms?
Even liver cancer does not have any symptoms. Pancreatic cancer, gallbladder cancer, and liver cancers so not have any symptoms, so they are very scary illnesses. With liver, if there is any symptom, it is always the late stage. So liver cancer really does not have any symptoms. The only notable symptoms are decreased appetite and lowered digestion ability. If jaundice is shown, it is always at late stage.
Is it like other cancers where it has levels, like level 1, level 2, level 3, level 4?
The most important level is the early stage, what is often called stage or level 1. When the cancer is small, that is when surgery must be performed. If not done, the cancer grows and becomes more difficult to treat. So, like other cancers, if one thinks there is liver inflammation, periodic exams to make sure it does not turn into cancer, and if caught in early stage surgery, can be done successfully either through excision, alone, or with transplant. Even if other methods are used, such as high-frequency radiation or other methods, it is more successful if done early.
So it's really important to know at the beginning. Yeah. How about the treatments? What are the treatment options for liver cancer?
That is a good question. The most preferred treatment is removal surgery. One is partial removal, and another is complete removal and transplant. But only about 20% qualify for this type of removal surgery. Of the remaining 70% cannot be treated. 50% cannot be treated. The remaining 20 to 30% can undergo other treatments such as high-frequency radiation and others. But the best results are from removal surgery, right? If the cancer is removed, it is the best. However, in order to do this surgery, the liver has to be in decent condition. But many have carried the inflammation for long periods and cannot be removed. So the best situation is to detect early and remove a small part of the liver. And even if detected later, it is better if the liver is in decent condition so that the transplant can be successfully done. And in cases where surgery is difficult, we treat with radial embolization or high-frequency radiation.
So, Dr. Choi, you talked about liver transfer. You said only 20% of people can do it.
Actually, not even. It is actually less than 10%. The patients who can get transplants are 10 to 20%. Most patients get diagnosed when it is at a late stage because they do not get regular checkups. In Korea, it's better, but in lesser developed nations, regular exams are rare. So when they show up for exams, it is usually when it is at a late stage. So treatment procedures such as surgery cannot be successfully done.
So what are the conditions for a liver transplant to be successful? Does it have to come from a family member?
The most important thing is that there has to be donors. But in Korea, there are not that many. In 1 year, there are only 300 to 400 donors. So most get the transplant from brothers or children. So in a given, about 1,500 transplants are from family members, while donated ones from strangers is about 300. In the West, it is reversed. The key to a transplant is having someone willing to give their liver. So in Korea, unless a family member is willing to give his or her liver, the transplant does not happen, especially in Korea.
So in the case of liver cancer, it has nothing to do with your history of family. For example, if you had somebody in your family who had liver cancer.
There is a little bit of relation. More important is if one's parents has hepatitis, it can be passed on. Most commonly in such situations is when a mother has hepatitis and her blood contaminates her child and gets passed on. Nowadays, a lot of that decreased due to vaccinations. But long ago, when hepatitis vaccines were not available, many became infected like that and used to be the top cause of liver infection.
So for liver cancer, if you, for example, cut the liver, does it come back, the cancer? Can it come back?
Yes, reoccurrence is common. So even after surgery, frequent exams are needed since it can reoccur. This is because even if we remove an infected portion, the remainder might still be infected. So it is really not reoccurrence, but more like a new cancer develops in the new area. This is because in the entire liver, there are conditions that are ripe for liver cancer development. So even if we remove the area, it can develop again in the new area. So the frequent and periodic screening is key so that if new cancers develop, quick treatment can be done successfully.
My last question, what is the ways to prevent liver cancer?
First, hepatitis B or C should be prevented. Second, limit alcohol intake. Third, stay away from becoming fat. So, limiting the conditions that can foster liver cancer and preventing liver infection. With liver infection, many develop into cancer, as liver cancer rarely forms with those without infection. So the best way to prevent liver cancer is not to get liver infection, but the reason liver gets infected depends on the country. Alcohol is the top reason. Then hepatitis B or C, and eating too much resulting in obesity and fatty liver. We can see the top three causes. After that, immunity, heredity, but those are rare. So the top three mentioned are the most common causes, so one prevents the top causes. He or she would prevent liver cancer. Thank you.
Liver cancer is cancer that starts in the liver, but this does not develop for a reason. There are many causes in Korea, for example, hepatitis B, and in the USA, alcohol-related liver issues, and if left as is for a prolonged period, cancer develops. So in Korea, hepatitis B-related inflammation, and in the USA and the West, it is alcohol-related conditions. Also, people who have fatty livers can also develop liver cancer, and that is increasing lately. So liver cancer can develop from a variety of conditions. But the key point is that if liver inflammation is left alone for a prolonged period, it can develop into cancer. With liver, if there's any symptom, it is often the late stage since liver cancer really does not have any early symptoms. The only notable symptoms are decreased appetite and lower digestion ability. If jaundice is shown, it is always at late stage. The most preferred treatment is removal surgery. One is partial removal and the other is complete removal and transplant. But only about 20% qualify for this type of removal surgery. Of the remaining 70%, 50% cannot be treated. The remaining 20 to 30% can undergo other treatments such as high-frequency radiation, but the best results are from removal surgery. However, in order to do this surgery, the liver has to be in decent condition. But many carry the inflammation for long periods and cannot be removed. So the best situation is to detect early and remove a small part of the liver. And even if detected later, it is better if the liver is in decent condition so that the transplant can be successfully done. And in cases where surgery is difficult, treatment with radioembolization, a high-frequency radiation, is also an option. Recurrence after surgery is common, especially if bad habits remain. It is thus important to limit fat intake and avoid alcohol. Thank you for joining us in yet another video covering key health-related topics with Cloud Hospital TV. If you have any questions or comments, please leave below and we will respond to you as soon as possible.